Hello, I am Alisha Raj and today I am going to discuss about motivation. When you come back from school, you feel hungry and want to eat something. You want to eat because there is a force which compels you to have food. Likewise, if a question is asked, why do you want to join a college? The answer can be given in various ways, like you want to learn or you need a degree or to get a good job. You may want to join college to have lots of friends. The basic questions of the why of behavior or factors which compel us to do certain activities makes us study the psychological process called motivation. Understanding motivation helps us to have insights into the dynamics of actions. In this chapter, we will know the meaning of motivation, the types of motives, differentiation between intrinsic and extrinsic motivation, self-efficacy, life goals and values as motivators, and the conflict and frustration. Let us know what is the meaning of motivation. Motivation refers to the factors which move or activate the organism. Motivation is seen when we find that people work towards certain goals. For example, we might observe that a student works hard at almost every task that comes to him or her. From this, we infer that the person has motive to achieve. All human behavior appears to arise in response to some form of internal, that is physiological, or external, that is environmental stimulation. This involves some purpose or goal. Thus, motivation can be defined as the process of activating, maintaining, and directing behavior towards a particular goal. Motivation is a process which is terminated once the desired goal is attained. Motivation is not always directly observed. It is inferred and used to explain behavior. In this picture, you can see how a rabbit is motivated to have a carrot. Motives also help us make predictions about behavior. Motives may give an idea about the range of activities a person will do. For example, an individual with a strong need to excel in sports will put in a lot of hard work in that field. Or someone interested in academics will do hard work in school. A student is very much motivated to get A+ in their report card. Now, let us move to concepts of motivation. First is needs and motives. Need is a condition of lack or deficit of something required by the organism. In order to maintain balance, the organism finds it necessary to satisfy the needs. The needs are of different types. The need for food or water is a physiological need, which arises out of lack or deficit of food or water in the organism. As you can see in this picture, every individual has their own needs depending on their environmental factors. The need for contact with other persons is a social need. The other social needs include need for prestige, status, affection, self-esteem, and so on. A person becomes more aware of his needs when they are not fulfilled. In this picture, you can see how each and every persons are connected with each other. In other words, when you are hungry, you need food, and when you are thirsty, you need water. The needs may be broadly categorized as primary or physiological needs and secondary or social needs. Needs for food, water, sex, sleep and rest, and elimination are primary needs. Needs for achievement, affiliation, power are examples of social needs. Every individual has their own goals for which they are motivated to achieve in their life. Thinking about the goal motivates a person to organize his or her action. If hunger is a need, eating food is a goal. Thus, goal is related to the need state. However, in certain cases, behavior is also guided by intrinsic goals. It means behavior does not always need external goals. It may be satisfying and enjoyable in itself. Some people may like to sing, dance, or play just for the sake of singing, dancing, or playing. They like such activities. Thus, goals can be intrinsic or extrinsic. In this picture, you can see how in every individuals are indulged in different activities which are motivated. Incentives refers to the goal objects which satisfy the needs. Incentives vary in quality and quantity, which make them less or more satisfying and attractive. Thus, one can put in greater amount of effort to attain a more attractive incentive. Instinct is defined as an innate biological force that predisposes the organism to act in a certain way, the instinct that guides you. Now, let us move to the hierarchy of needs. Abraham Maslow gave the concept of needs. There are several levels of needs that each person must strive to meet before he or she can achieve the highest level of personal fulfillment. This is a pictorial graph that represents the hierarchy of needs given by Maslow. Physiological needs. The most potent and lowest level of all the needs are physiological needs, which are shown in the picture given below. Safety needs are mainly concerned with maintaining order and security to feel secure. Love and belongingness needs are the needs of making intimate relationship. People want to become an accepted member of the organized group, need a familiar environment such as family. Now, let us know the esteem needs. Needs are related to respect from others like reputation, status, social success, and fame. For example, a competent professional who has established a high reputation and does not have to worry about getting a job may become quite choosy about what type of work he/she should accept. Self-esteem. Self-respect and self-regard need to achieve to be competent, to gain approval, and to get recognition. The need to feel superior to others also falls under this category. Self-actualization refers to the desire to utilize one's personal capacities to develop one's potentialities to the fullest and to engage in activities for which one is well suited. One should realize and be satisfied that he or she has achieved what one is capable of. Self-transcendence is the highest level of need where a person becomes conscious of broader reality. At this level, one becomes aware of the entire humanity. At this level, spiritual concerns become very important. Now, let us know what do we mean by achievement motivation. Achievement motivation is one of the important needs for achievement or the need to attain excellence and higher level of performance. People in whom the need for achievement is strong seek difficult work and improve their task performance. They are future-oriented, aspire for higher goals and persist on the task chosen. In this picture, we can see how a person is motivated to achieve the first rank, and in this scenario, every person moves to have the first position. Motivations are of two types, intrinsic motivation and extrinsic motivation. While thinking about motivation, we often try to locate its source, whether it is internal to the person or external to him or her. In situations where the locus of control is external to the person who is asked to undertake the activity, such situations characterize the kind of motivation which is extrinsic. But when the locus of control is inside, for example, when we work because the task itself is interesting and does not require any external source of motivation, this situation represents intrinsic motivation, such as reading an interesting novel. Second is self-efficacy. Self-efficacy was introduced by Bandura. The concept of self-efficacy has been used to motivate people in a variety of settings. By learning appropriate or realistic self-efficacy beliefs, one can plan behaviors and perform at a higher level. Second is values. Values work as important motivators. They are considered as desirable and cherishable goals that serve as guiding principles in people's life. Values help to make a choice. These are the most important values of our life. Some of these values are power, which means social status and prestige, control and dominance over people and resources. Second is achievement, which includes personal success by demonstrating competence according to social standards. Third, self-direction, independent thought and action, choosing, creating, and exploring. Universalism includes understanding, appreciation, tolerance, and protection for the welfare of all people. Benevolence includes preservation and enhancement of welfare of people with whom one is in frequent personal contact. Tradition. Tradition includes respect, commitment, and acceptance of the customs and ideas that are given importance in the traditional cultures or religions. Conformity. This includes restraints of action, inclination, and impulses likely to upset or harm others and violate social expectations or norms. Security. This includes safety, harmony, and stability of society, of relationships, and of self. Now let us move to frustration and conflict. When our needs are not satisfied, we get frustrated. Frustration refers to the blocking of behavior directed towards a goal. If motives are frustrated or blocked, the person may feel anxious, depressed, or angry. For example, if you want to go to a movie or want to play and your parents refuse permission, you may show some kind of disturbed behavior such as anger and shouting. Sources of frustrations are very in common. First is environmental forces. The environmental factors can frustrate the satisfaction of motives. The obstacle may be physical, such as roadblock, or they may be social, as your parents may prevent you from doing something what you want to do. Second is personal factors or limitations. The personal characteristics of individual, like personality or intelligence, affect performance. The limitations of ability frustrate individuals because they do not let him or her to achieve very high goals. At times, we have conflicting goals which create frustration. Now let us know what do we mean by conflict. We sometimes face a situation where we are supposed to choose between two or more alternatives. For example, we may have to decide whether to buy a book or go to a movie. There are three types of conflicts: approach-approach conflict, avoidance-avoidance conflict, and approach-avoidance conflict. Approach-approach conflict. For example, you are offered admission to two equally attractive courses of study for higher education and you have to decide between them. Avoidance-avoidance conflict. It occurs when we have to decide between two equally undesirable and negative goals. For example, such a conflict may arise when you have to choose between goals that are equally disliked by you. Third is approach-avoidance conflict. In approach-avoidance conflict arises when there are both desirable and undesirable feelings associated with a single goal. This is the most easiest conflict you can ever have because one side is positive and the other is negative. For example, you want to marry a girl you love but your parents do not agree to it. So you cannot marry her as you do not want to hurt your parents. This kind of conflict is most difficult to resolve and brings emotional discomfort. This was all about this program today, and now let us sum up the discussions we have done today. Motivation is a process of initiating action, and the key concepts of motivations are needs and motives, goals, incentives, instincts, hierarchy of needs, different types of needs. We came to know about achievement motivation. What do we mean by intrinsic and extrinsic motivation? Self-efficacy, beliefs about own, values, that is guiding principles of our behavior, frustration and conflict, which is blocks in the attempts to satisfy needs. Thank you.